Liner crew capsule should already be alternating with SpaceX, taking astronauts to the International Space Station, but it has faced many delays.
WESH 2's Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler is joining us live now with how those delays might be coming to an end. And Scott, mission managers gave an update today.
Boeing Starliner is the second spacecraft that's part of NASA's commercial spaceflight program, commercial crew program. But unlike SpaceX's Crew Dragon, it has not yet taken any astronauts up to the International Space Station. After repeated delays for the first crewed test mission, NASA and Boeing flight managers giving an update on the Starliner test mission, a critical hurdle.
And really, this is the final piece to say that the vehicle is ready to go fly the missions and become human rated for that mission.
He said that they are 80% done and aiming for an April liftoff from the Kennedy Space Center. The eight-day mission to the ISS will have two crew members, coming at a very busy time for the station, with crew rotations and Russia's Roscosmos dealing with a damaged Soyuz capsule docked at the ISS. Any delays from Starliner could impact other missions. The teams have been working through issues uncovered from Starliner's uncrewed test mission last May. And that was a follow-up to a 2019 test mission that was cut short due to technical issues.
We've done our designs, we've tested this hardware, the analysis is all done. So now this is the kind of, let's wrap it all up in a bow and make sure that we did what we said we were going to do, and we have all the artifacts to prove it.
Unlike SpaceX, where its Dragon capsule is launched on top of its Falcon 9 rocket, Boeing's Starliner gets its ride to low Earth orbit on a ULA Atlas rocket. SpaceX has been flying astronauts up to the ISS since 2020. Its Crew 6 mission is planned for later in the month.
Make no mistake, NASA will be thrilled to have redundant access to the International Space Station. You know, once Starliner gets flying, they'll have Dragon, Starliner, and then as a third backup, they'll have, or as a second backup, they'll have the Soyuz spacecraft that's built by Russia.
An interesting point brought up by Eric there at Ars Technica is that there's growing concern inside NASA as well as outside about the ongoing war, Russia's war with Ukraine, and how that could have an impact on quality control of the space industry in Russia. So that's something that is growing concern. And so, but right now, that underlines the importance of another operational way to get up to the ISS. Reporting live on the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.